unveiled what features are coming up in Android P, iPhone users started trolling Google for copying iPhone 10 gestures. Though the upcoming software version of Android has got many new features and changes, yet new Android P gestures are something you need to master right now. When I got my hands on new Android P gestures, I was like, wow man, this is amazing. Though Android P gestures are similar to iPhone 10 gestures, yet there are differences, and for a good reason. Hey, what's up everyone, Rahul here from techreport.com, and in this video I'll help you master new Android P gestures. You will also come to know about the differences between new Android P gestures and iPhone 10 gestures. So without further ado, let's get started. First thing first, Android P gestures are not mandatory. If you don't like them, you may keep them disabled. But if you have got Android P on your phone and want to get started with Android P gestures right now, head on to settings. Tap on system. Here you will see gestures. Tap on it and you will see many gestures your phone has got. All you need to do is tap on each gesture and turn it on. Now go to home and you are ready to launch new Android P gestures. As you can see, a new layout for home button. Short swipe up from bottom and you will see recent apps. Swipe down to reach home. However, if you swipe down from the app screen, this opens up that application. On iPhone 10, you swipe up from bottom and hold it. Now you must be thinking how to open app drawer. Simply swipe up from bottom of the screen and swipe up again. This opens up app drawer. Alternatively, you may also long swipe up from the home screen to open app drawer in one swipe. But how do you switch between apps? Well, there are two ways to do that. On recent apps screen, you may either swipe left or right from bottom of the screen and then swipe down to open that app. On the other hand, you may also drag the home button left to right to get a preview of all the recent apps. Keep dragging the home button while holding it and release it on the app which you want to open. On iPhone 10, you swipe up from bottom of the screen and hold it, then swipe left to select apps you want to switch to. How do you switch to previous apps on Android P? Swipe right from bottom of the home screen. It simply switches you to the previous apps. Although long pressing home button might activate Google Assistant sometimes, which is irritating. I think Google should find a way to deal that with a physical button, just like long pressing power button activates Siri on iPhone 10. However, on iPhone 10, you simply swipe left or right to switch between previous apps. How to minimize apps on Android P? Well, it hasn't changed much. When you have any app open, simply touch the home button or swipe up from bottom of screen and then tap home button. On iPhone 10, you swipe up from bottom of screen as there is no home button. How to close apps on Android P? To close any app, Android P has got a more complex gesture than earlier Android versions. Starting from Android Lollipop to Android Oreo, you could simply swipe left or right from the minimized app stacks to close any app. However, to achieve the same with Android P gesture, you need to swipe up from bottom of the screen and then drag the app stack upwards. On iPhone 10, you swipe up and hold to open recent apps, then hold it for a fraction of a second until you see red minus sign. Now swipe up the app stack to close it. If you want to click a picture in hurry, you can double press the power button and this will open up camera app quickly. On iPhone 10, you can 3D touch the camera icon from lock screen or simply swipe right to open camera app instantly. When you have Google camera app open, you may double twist your phone to switch between selfie mode and rear camera mode, although this is not primarily an Android P gesture. Another cool Android P gesture is to activate vibrate mode. You can press volume up button and power button simultaneously to activate vibrate mode quickly. On iPhone X, well, there is a physical button and it has existed for many years. How to open Control Center quickly. If you pull down from top of screen, this opens up notifications. If you do it again, and this opens up Control Center. Alternatively, you may also swipe down your finger on fingerprint scanner to achieve the same. But what if you want to open Control Center quickly? A useful Android gesture is to swipe down from top of screen using your two fingers. This opens up entire Control Center at once. On iPhone X, you swipe down from top right corner of screen to open Control Center. While swiping down from left corner opens up Notification Center. I think Android P should get a similar control to separate notifications from Control Center, because even if you swipe with two fingers, notifications stick there. So this wraps up our list of cool Android P gestures. Although Android P has got lots of inspiration from iPhone X gestures, yet it has mastered a few things in a better way. And I think it's for a good reason, because when Apple removed headphone jack, almost 90% of Android manufacturers removed it. When Apple introduced that controversial notch, many Android manufacturers have already started adopting it. And believe me, the Face ID is not too far away. So being the core supplier of software for these manufacturers, Google has to find a way to bring those gestures to Android as well. If you ask me from a user's perspective, I use iPhone X as well as Google Pixel. Having gestures on iPhone X was exciting, but I was lacking something on Android. These cool Android P gestures ensure that I get best of both worlds. What do you think about new Android P gestures? Do let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed watching this video, please give me a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends. If you want more cool tips, tricks and reviews like this, please make sure you subscribe to TechReview's channel and tap on the bell icon to get instant notifications, because we have more interesting videos coming up for you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.